answering Google's most asked questions about antibiotic resistance.
Hi, I'm Andrew Boyden. I'm a GP and I'm also a medical advisor for NPS MedicineWise. I'm here to answer Google's most commonly asked questions about antibiotic resistance. So let's get started. Yes, it's very real. It's a worldwide problem, and it's also here in Australia with us now. And we really need to get on top of this to preserve the miracle of antibiotics for the future. Antibiotic resistance occurs when antibiotics no longer are effective in treating bacterial infections as well as they used to be. And they occur because bacteria change to protect themselves from the medication. Yes, definitely, and it's becoming worse. We have evidence of multiple different bacteria becoming increasingly resistant to a whole range of antibiotics. MRSA, also known as golden staph, it can be picked up in hospitals and unfortunately is increasingly being picked up in the community. Gonorrhea, a sexually transmitted infection picked up through unprotected sex, increasingly becoming resistant to antibiotics. And this is just a couple of examples. It's dangerous now because it's leading to fewer options to treat serious bacterial infections. This means people can be sicker for longer, they might need to stay in hospital for longer. In some cases, it even can be a life-threatening situation. Yes, if things don't change, we have a really big worldwide public health problem here. The World Health Organization says this is one of the greatest threats facing human health worldwide currently. Firstly, only take antibiotics as prescribed and directed by your doctor. Secondly, don't ask for antibiotics for cold and flu. They don't work for viruses. And thirdly, practice good hygiene, including hand washing, to prevent the spread of bacteria. And if you'd like to learn more about antibiotic resistance, please visit our website.
Visit nps.org.au to learn more.